Hello friends and welcome to Pendulum Media. Today we'll be discussing daily current affairs of 12 June 2020. So let's start the session. For the first time in the country, the number of people recovering from COVID-19 infection is more than its patient. And this is good news in the direction of controlling this disease. So far, 135,205 COVID-19 patients in the country have been cured, while the current number of infected population is 133,632. These people are undergoing treatment. The recovery rate in the country has risen to 48.88%. So let's see a question. Which of the following statements is correct? For the first time in the country, the number of people recovering from COVID-19 pandemic has exceeded its patients. Second, COVID-19 is a disease caused by bacteria. You have to select the correct answer using the codes given below. One only, two only, both one and two, none. So the correct answer is option A, that is one only. Second statement is wrong because COVID-19 is caused by virus, and that virus has been named as SARS-CoV-2, and the disease caused by this SARS-CoV-2 is COVID-19, that is coronavirus disease 2019. Moving to the next news, annual allocation of rupees 4000 crore to states under per drop more crop for the year 2020-21. An annual allocation of rupees 4000 crore has been made to the states under the per drop more crop component of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana for the year 2020-21. Recently, Union Minister of Agriculture has announced this, and also the government has created a micro irrigation fund of 5000 crore rupees with NABARD. The purpose of this fund is to facilitate the states in mobilizing resources for the expansion of micro irrigation. The plan is to increase water use efficiency at the farm level through drip and sprinkler irrigation systems and other irrigation technologies. Drip micro irrigation technology not only helps in saving water, but it also helps in reducing fertilizer usage, labor expenses, and other agriculture input cost. Now let's see a question related to the news. How much amount has been allocated annually to the states under the per drop more crop component of the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana for the year 2020-21? 4000 crore, 5000 crore, 6000 crore and 7000 crores. So the correct answer is option A, that is 4000 crores. Moving to the next news, inauguration of deep submerged rescue vehicle DSRV complex at Visakhapatnam. Recently, the DSRV complex, a deep submerged rescue vehicle, was inaugurated in Visakhapatnam. The DSRV complex is designed to accommodate the newly incorporated submarine rescue system. The DSRV system consists of a submarine rescue vessel, a remote operation vehicle, side scan sonar and related equipment. It is the dive chamber and hyperbaric medical equipment to dismantle the submarine after rescuing the submerged marine. The DSRV system can be rapidly abandoned by air or road to facilitate submarine rescue operations even at distant locations. The Indian Navy has incorporated two such systems that will provide rescue cover to submarines on the west and east coast of India respectively. Now let's see a question related to this. Where has the DSRV complex inaugurated recently in India? Cochin, Visakhapatnam, Tuticorin and Kandla. So the correct answer is option B, that is Visakhapatnam. Bangladesh government has launched an online network to facilitate plasma exchange for the treatment of COVID-19. Recently, Bangladesh government has launched an online network to facilitate the plasma exchange in the country for the treatment of COVID-19. The name of this initiative is Sojodha. The number of people infected with corona in Bangladesh has risen to 71,000, while it has killed 975 people so far. Talking about convalescent plasma therapy, in this therapy, the recent convalescent cell of a person recovering from infection are injected into another patient of COVID-19. As the patient recovering from the disease will have antibodies that can help other patients get rid of the coronavirus. Talking about Bangladesh, it is located in east of India on the Bay of Bengal coast, and its capital is Dhaka and the currency is Bangladeshi Taka. Here you can see the location of Bangladesh in map. It shares its border with West Bengal, Assam, Meghalaya and Tripura. And also India shares its longest border with Bangladesh. Moving to the question part, Bangladesh government has launched an online network to facilitate the plasma exchange for the treatment of COVID-19. What is the name of this initiative? सहायक, विधान, शोजोदा एंड सारथी. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, दैट इज शोजोदा. मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज, उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट डायरेक्टेड टू स्टार्ट ट्रूनेट मशीन इन ऑल 75 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स बाय 15 जून. रिसेंटली उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट योगी आदित्यनाथ हैज इंस्ट्रक्टेड टू कमीशन द ट्रूनेट मशीन इन ऑल 75 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ द स्टेट्स बाय 15 जून 2020. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज मशीन्स द नंबर ऑफ कोविड 19 टेस्ट कैन बी इंक्रीज. रिसेंटली ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research, approved the use of TrueNet machine for coronavirus screening test. TrueNet machines are used to test drug-resistant tuberculosis. Talking about Uttar Pradesh, it is the most populous state in India. The Chief Minister of state is Yogi Adityanath and Governor is Anandiben Patel. The capital of the state is Lucknow. The state bird of Uttar Pradesh is swamp deer. State bird is Saras crane. State tree is Ashok and state flower is Brahmakamal. The questions have been asked in past regarding the state symbols. So you have to read that what are the different state symbols of particular states in India. Uttar Pradesh has 80 seats in the Lok Sabha and 403 assembly seats. Moving to the question part, what is the state tree of Uttar Pradesh? Ashok, Banyan, Peepal and Neem. So the correct answer is option A, that is Ashok. Moving to the next news. S&P retained India's BBB- rating with a stable outlook. Recently, S&P has retained India's rating as BBB- with a stable outlook. According to S&P, that is Standard & Poor's, risks to development are increasing, but India's economy will soon stabilize after the control of COVID-19 pandemic and the fiscal situation will begin to recover from 2021. The S&P also said that the stagnant outlook also assumes that government's fiscal deficit may decrease significantly after a multi-year high in fiscal year 2020. What is this fiscal deficit? It is the difference between the government's total income and total expenditure. S&P Standard & Poor's Global Ratings, it is an American credit rating agency that was founded in 1860. It is headquartered in New York, United States. There are three big credit rating agencies. One is Moody's. Second is S&P, that is Standard & Poor's, and third is Fitch Ratings. Now the question, what rating has S&P recently given to India? BBB-, BB, BBA- and BA. So the correct answer is option A, that is BBB-. Next is increase in the number of Asiatic lions by about 29%. Recently, population assessment exercise was done in the Gir Forest area. It saw an increase of 29%. The number of Asiatic lions has increased to 674 in Gir Forest region and other revenue regions of coastal Saurashtra. The last count was the lion population of 523 in 2015, which has increased to about 29%. The distribution of lions has increased from 22,000 square kilometer in 2015 to 30,000 square kilometer in 2020. According to Forest Department data, the male-female ratio in the forest area is 161 males per 260 females. These Asiatic lions, their natural habitat is only Gir Forest region in India. And the IUCN status of this Asiatic lion is endangered, and also these are protected under Wildlife Protection Act of 1972 under Schedule 1 of the Act. Moving to the question part, recently about how much percent increase in the number of Asiatic lions has been recorded? 10, 15, 29 and 20. So the correct answer is option C, that is 29%. Moving to the next news, Raymond Magsaysay Award cancelled this year due to coronavirus pandemic. It has been cancelled in past also due to financial crisis in 1970 and the devastating earthquake in the Philippines in 1990. And this is the third time the awards have been cancelled. Raymond Magsaysay Award, it is the highest honor in Asia and is considered the equivalent of the Nobel Prize. The award is given annually to individuals or organizations in the Asia region for philanthropy and social service. The award was established in 1957 in the memory of Ramon Magsaysay, the third president of Philippines. Now the question part. Regarding the Ramon Magsaysay Award, which of the following statements is not true? It is the highest honor of Asia. This statement is true. It was established in 1957 in the memory of Ramon Magsaysay, the third president of Vietnam. This statement is wrong because Ramon Magsaysay was the third president of Philippines. So the correct code will be 1 only. This is true. So the correct answer will be 2 only. That is, the wrong statement is second one. So B will be the correct answer for this. Moving to the next news. Largest biodiversity park of Uttarakhand opened in Haldwani. Recently, the state's largest biodiversity park has opened in Haldwani, Uttarakhand. And this was inaugurated on 5 June on the occasion of World Environment Day. And the theme for World Environment Day 2020 was celebrating biodiversity. Biodiversity parks are a natural storehouse of plant and animal varieties. The park has thematic gardens and earthen museum, plant species, lichen, a vermicompost unit and algae of moss and Jurassic age. An interpretation center and a state-of-the-art weather station has also been built. Talking about Uttarakhand, it was carved out of northern Uttar Pradesh on 9 November 2000 as the 27th state of India. The chief minister of Uttarakhand is Trivendra Singh Rawat and the governor is Baby Rani Maurya. Now the question part, in which district of Uttarakhand the largest biodiversity park of the state has been opened? Haldwani, Nainital, Roorkee and Dehradun. So the correct answer is option A, that is Haldwani. Moving to the next news, Himachal Pradesh government's attempt to boost hing and saffron yields. The government of Himachal Pradesh has entered into an agreement with Institute of Himalayan Bioresource Technology to boost the yield of Asafoetida or hing and saffron. The Institute of Himalayan Bioresource Technology is the only laboratory of the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research in Himachal Pradesh. A state-of-the-art tissue culture lab will be established for mass production of quality planting material of both these crops. Under this scheme, new varieties of saffron and hing from exporting countries will be standardized according to Indian conditions. Asafoetida or hing, it is a perennial plant and it produces oleogum resin from the roots after 5 years of planting. It can be grown on land with unusable slopes of cold desert area. Currently, India does not produce asafoetida or hing and around 1200 tons of raw asafoetida is being imported from Afghanistan, Iran and Uzbekistan. Talking about saffron, in India, saffron is currently cultivated on approximately 2825 hectares of land in Jammu and Kashmir. And recently, Kashmir saffron has got Geographical Indication Tag or GI Tag. Now the question part, Himachal Pradesh government has tied up with Institute of Himalayan Bioresource Technology to boost the yield of which spices? Asafoetida, saffron, black pepper, both A and B. So the correct answer is option D, that is both A and B. So friends, here we have comprehensively covered daily current affairs of 12 June 2020. I hope you like this session and you are daily following this. You can also read the current affairs in English and as well as in Hindi from our website pedlamedu.com. You can also download the PDF and also you can attempt daily current affair quiz, exam wise quiz, subject wise quiz for your practice. And subscribe to our channel Pendulum Edu and do not forget to press the bell icon to receive notification and keep preparing with us. All the best. Thank you.